Thank you. Jesus, born to set thy people free from our fears and sins. Release us, let us find our rest in thee. Israel, strength and consolation, above all the earth thou art. Dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart. Born thy people to deliver, born a child and yet a king, born to reign in us forever, now thy gracious kingdom bring. By thine own eternal spirit, rule in all our hearts alone. By thine all-sufficient merit, raise us to
service on the longest night of the year. This is the winter solstice, December 21st. Welcome to all who are worshiping online today. Today we acknowledge in this worship service that Christmas can be a difficult time for many of us. It connects with our grief and our loss. It may be the first Christmas after a big life change, the death of a loved one, a lost job, a broken relationship, a long illness, weeks with less hours of daylight may take a toll on folks. It may be a challenging time because it brings up family disappointment and fracture. The constant refrain in the media these days is one of happiness, joy, laughter, families and friends being together. But this might remind some of what they have lost or what they have never had. So we acknowledge that Christmas can be a difficult time for many. And we also know that God meets us wherever we are tonight. Amen? God meets us wherever we are. We recognize in this season of Advent leading to Christmas that we hold lament and grief as well as joy and hope. We hold them together. God has created us human beings with emotions and feelings, and the mixture of emotions is also present in this season. Lament in the Bible is an expression of sorrow. It's a description of distress. It can be a protest against injustice. In a culture that we live in that's so often in a state of denial, lament helps us identify our personal and our communal pain and express it honestly, name it, and bring it to God. Bring it to God. Lament becomes a prayerful plea to God for help, for healing, for wholeness, for justice. For individuals, for families, for the church, for communities, for our nation, for our world. So we offer our lament tonight. We bring the lament that is in our hearts to God, and we open ourselves up at the same time to listen for a word of healing, a word of hope from God. So I ask you this question and invite you into some moments of quiet to think about it. What brings you tonight to this longest night service? And how are you doing? How do you bring yourself to the service tonight? What's happening within you? Take some moments to just think about that. I invite folks who are online today, if you would like to respond by putting something, a comment into the chat, feel free to do that. Just to give a space for any who would like to share anything on your heart as you enter this worship space today, does anyone want to share what brings you here tonight? I can come to you and you can just share it into the microphone. Okay.
Well, I'd just like to entertain having a personal relationship with Christ, so spending more time meditating on His Word, and more time on spending time in His presence.
Thank you.
The death of my son, strength and comfort. That's why I'm here. I think about him every single day. It gets better, but it's just I need comfort and strength from the Lord. I need His strength.
Just to be reminded that even in the midst of all the joy, we can still hold grief and lament, and that God holds space for that.
Will you join me on the bold print? And for those who are worshiping online, in an all-church email, there is a link to this order of service for the longest night service. Tonight, we gather here in this place of refuge. For we are lost, we are lonely, we are afraid. Tonight we gather daring to wonder if God has indeed come in Jesus, discerning the rejection we have known, intimate with our failed relationships, holding our heartache in hands of tenderness. Tonight we gather with strangers and neighbors, a family made one by our brokenness, coming with our hearts full of hope, and our pockets filled with doubts. Tonight we gather just as we are, for God has promised to meet us here and to welcome us for who we are. Throughout this service, there'll be some moments of quiet reflection. We'll take a moment to center ourselves quietly in God. God of love, you invite us to bring all of who we are to you, our fears, our doubts, our hopes, our dreams, God, our feelings and emotions, situations, concerns, relationships that are on our minds and in our hearts. Thank you, God, for meeting us here, for meeting each of us wherever we are tonight. Thank you especially for walking with us in sadness and in grief and in loss, for reminding us we're not alone, for entering our world and our lives as one of us, and as the Christmas story tells us, for experiencing all the joys and the sorrows of human existence, including suffering and death. God, we open our hearts, minds, and spirit to your presence tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Our first scripture reading.
The scripture reading is from Psalms 13, verses 1 through 3. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I bear pain in my soul and have sorrow in my heart all day long? How long shall my enemy be exalted over me? Consider and answer me, O Lord my God. Give light to my eyes, or I will sleep the sleep of death.
Thank you.
We enter now into a litany of remembrance and candle lighting. And we'll be lighting 6 candles now, each candle together with a petition. We'll be remembering those experiencing hurt and hopelessness this evening. And after we share this litany together, it'll be an opportunity for you who are here in person to come forward and light a candle or several candles, and you can do that in each one of the areas of the petitions that we lift up today. If you think of a person or situation you'd like to be praying for in grief or in a situation of violence, you can light a candle in that area. And if you are worshiping online today and you have candles wherever you are, you can light a candle or candles during this time. So the first candle. We light this first candle to remember those who are captive to fear and anxiety, for those lost in the night of addiction, depression, or hopelessness. We pray to God who guided the Israelites through the night with a pillar of fire. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night. We light this second candle to remember those who have died and those who are grieving the deaths of loved ones. The shadow of death can seem impenetrable during these long nights. We pray to God, whose first act in creation was to speak light in the midst of darkness. Death's dark shadow put to flight. We light this third candle to remember those who are lonely or alone. We remember those who are isolated from loved ones, far from home, wandering down lonely paths, or convinced that God is unconcerned with their suffering. We pray to God, who is like the woman who lit a lantern to search all night for one lost coin. Refresh the hearts that long for you. We light this fourth candle to remember those who are facing illness. We lift up those who suffer the pain, isolation, and fear that accompany a broken body. For all who desire to be returned to wholeness, we pray to God, who lit the night sky with a star to guide 3 magi to the healing Christ. Restore the broken, make us new. We light this fifth candle to remember those who feel that hardship and loss will overwhelm them. For those experiencing economic poverty, loss of jobs, hunger, homelessness and persecution. We pray to God who walked with three men through the consuming flames of a fiery furnace. In strength and beauty, come and stay. We light this final candle to remember those affected by war and violence, for soldiers, for civilians in war-torn nations, for families who mourn the loss of loved ones to violence. We pray to God with eyes of blazing fire who promises a vision of peace. Teach us your will and guide our way. And now, as Kathy plays some instrumental music, an opportunity for you to come forward as you would like, or wherever you are, light a candle here, light a candle or candles, and pray. Lift up your petition to God in quiet. We'll take the time that we need to do that.
Thank you.
we've had an opportunity to light candles and to reflect, an opportunity now for those who would like to share your lament, to share a person or people, experiences, a situation, a loss, an injustice that's burdening your heart today. If you'd like to share that out loud, I'll come to you with a microphone, because sometimes when we don't carry it alone and we're willing to put it out there for others to hear, it helps us. Helps us know we're not alone. Helps us know that the community is there. And if you are worshiping online and you would like to lift up in the comment section a concern that you have, again, people, experiences, situations of grief, loss, injustice, or general concern, please lift those up and I'll gather them now. So I'll come to you if you would like to share it out loud.
I've been struggling lately with anxiety, so I'm just thankful for doctors, but also, you know, grieving and praying for God to meet me in those places. Also for my very good friend, whose name is Abby, and her dad passed away, and today is his birthday, and so just saw her post that today, so just, yeah.
But I will need my daughter to interpret to me, because sometimes English is very difficult to me.
Here, I'll let you.
Amen. Nilita sema, nilita sema juu ya vita yenye kwetu ya ili yenye wanasema Congo na Rwanda.
I'm just lifting up prayers for my country, Congo, and the war that's going on between Congo and Rwanda right now.
Tuko tuliishi sana na Banyarwanda, sabili bandugu, barafiki, na tuko na barafiki mingi, na tushakuwa barafiki mingi sana na Banyarwanda, lakini hii vita natuma tunataka ingia ndani ya Zambia ya kunungunika.
Most of us have grown up with Rwandese friends. Some of them are our family and friends and neighbors. And now we're just in this place of division that's making us feel very conflicted. You try to forget the difficult things that are happening, but then another thing happens and it restarts all the pain and the... So around this time, I want to especially lift those two countries to God for peace and to just help us find a way to bring unity between both.
In the first candle, I have many members, family members, and in the of fear, they're fearful, and God didn't give us the spirit of fear. He gave us the power to know him and a sound mind. That means I want them to know Christ for themselves. And then in the grieving, that he's with us no matter what. He's going to give us that strength that we need and that comfort we need, that we've lost loved ones. Not only did I lose my brother, my son, I lost a brother, lost a mom, a dad. So he's comforted me in all of that, but I still miss them on this earth. But I know they're in a better place. They have no more pain. And then on the, have a lot of, and then on this one, lonely, family members that are lonely, he'll never leave you nor forsake you. He's with us always. With my loved ones, and then illness, by his stripes, we are healed. He bore our sicknesses and healed all of our diseases. That's what he can do for us. That's what he will do for us. And that's what I'm praying for my family. And then on the last one, hardship with the war and poverty. He wants us prosperous. He wants everything for us on this earth. He doesn't want us to live in poverty. So we're praying for those that are out there that are living in homelessness. They probably really don't realize they can be prosperous, but they don't know how. So that's my prayer for them.
Well, first of all, I know that I'm grieving my relationship with Christ, our first nature, as we were created. And now I'm beginning to grieve the relationship with this world and all these things, this war, this illness, and all this stuff has to happen here now. It has to happen. And although I long to be joined with Christ again in our first nature, I have to let this world go. And it's grieving, but I see it coming.
There are others who would like to share a grief or loss. We lift up some others on behalf of our community. Pray for the Plain family at the death of Pastor Holly Plain, a pillar in our community, blessed pastor who served here at Peace for 32 years. We pray for Carol, his wife, and children, and for this whole community in grief. Pray for those who are without the warmth of a permanent place to live, experiencing homelessness, especially on these long, cold nights. And we grieve tonight the loss of life of 167 people in Pierce County who died this year while living on the streets without a permanent homes. We grieve also the impact of systemic racism in our community and in our families, and also the lack of signs of true progress toward racial justice in our nation and our society. And I lift up grief for violence on our streets and in our homes and throughout our world. As we've heard, a petition for Congo, a petition also for Ukraine and Russia, Afghanistan, many places in the world where there is unrest and innocent lives are being lost. And we lift up that reality right here in the Hilltop neighborhood. God of compassion, we lift up all these laments and all the others that are on our hearts and our minds, people, experiences, situations that burden us. And we remember Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." We come to you. We bring these burdens to you. We trust that you will carry them with us and for us. We pray for healing, for hope, for courage, for rest, and for peace. In your holy name, amen. I invite you now, and Naomi started to get to this place. I invite you to listen to God's word of comfort and hope. And so I'm going to invite Emily forward for the gospel reading from Matthew 5.
The Gospel reading, Matthew 5, verses 3 through 11. Now, When Jesus saw the crowd, he went up on the mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Amen. These are blessings for us today. Again, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are those who are persecuted. The psalmist in Psalm 23, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me." Psalmist in Psalm 30, "Weeping will linger for the night, but joy comes with the morning." The Apostle Paul in Romans 8, "I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." The good news of Christmas is that God hears our lament. And though we may wish that God magically take away the pain and the hurt and the suffering of ourselves and our families and our world, God chooses to do something so much more profound. God chooses to enter into our pain and our hurt and our suffering, meeting us in person to show us God's love, to bring us along the path toward healing and wholeness and peace and hope. God's message to us today is, don't be afraid. I am with you. In the words of Jesus, "Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." We may search and search for answers and solutions. In the end, our ultimate hope is found in God. Amen?
Amen.
Who has come to be with us in Jesus. Let's sing, "All Earth is Hopeful."
Last furrows lie open.
receive this blessing for the longest night. This is from Jan Richardson in the collection, The Cure for Sorrow. All throughout these months, as the shadows have lengthened, this blessing has been gathering itself, making ready, preparing for this night. It has practiced walking in the dark, traveling with its eyes closed, feeling its memory, feeling its way by memory, by touch, by the pull of the moon, even as it wanes. So believe me when I tell you this blessing will reach you even if you have not light enough to read it. It will find you even though you cannot see it coming. You will know the moment of it arriving by your release of the breath you've held so long, a loosening of the clenching in your hands, of the clutch around your heart, a thinning of the darkness that had drawn itself around you. This blessing does not mean to take the night away. But it knows its hidden roads, knows the resting spots along the path, knows what it means to travel in the company of a friend. So when this blessing comes, take its hand, get up. Set out on the road you cannot see. This is the night when you can trust that any direction you go, you will be walking toward the dawn. Let us pray. God, may we rest in your expansive and infinite darkness. May that darkness be a sign of peace and comfort for us this night. Amen. If you would like to stay as we conclude this time of worship, you're invited to do that. If you'd like to pray, light some more candles, spend some time in quiet. Take your time. Now please receive these words of blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may go or stay in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.